Hi, this is Hadas in Canva, and in this tutorial I'd like to show you how you can customize and create your own back-to-school labels or stickers for your kids. Are you ready? Let's go! I'll demonstrate this using my own templates that you can find on Canva's marketplace. If you'd like to use these exact templates, I'm attaching a link to those templates at the comments below. Feel free to use them, they are absolutely free. So, are you ready? Let's go! But before we start, if you'd like to see how I've created this from scratch, I'll walk you through step by step. So I picked an A4 document, and now all I have to do is add the frame of my sticker. For this, I just head out to Elements and searched for a doodle frame. You can also search for a scribble frame, dashed frame, or any other rectangle that you'd like. So let's pick one that we like. I search for a doodle frame, filter this to graphics only, and picked this one. The reason I like this one is because it's adjustable. I can edit its colors, as you can see right at the top here. So what I'm going to do is duplicate this four times. Four times would be a good decent size for a label for my notebooks or books. So let's go to copy paste. Paste this four times, and to make sure that this is perfectly aligned and spaced, just choose them all, go to position, and click on tidy up. Now just repeat this so we can paste it on the left side of our canvas. Copy them all and paste them. Now if you'd like to edit the colors one by one, you can just go to each one and change their colors. I'm going to zoom in because now I'm going to add some text. Go to text, add a heading, and type in whatever you'd like. I'll type in name, and adjust the font, the size, and place it exactly where I want it. My next step would be to add a line. Go to Elements and click on Lines and Shapes and pick your line. You can also just hit the L tab and you'll get an automatic line that you can adjust. You could just go to the top white menu and adjust the style of your line. So I'm going to go with a dotted line, make a few adjustments, and that's it. All you have to do now is copy paste and repeat the process until you're happy with what you have. That's how easy it is to create it from scratch. But if you'd like to adjust my templates, let's see how easy that is. So I've started with this template that I've created with some cute animals. What you can do is either use this as it is, or if you'd like to customize this according to what your kid loves, then you can easily do that. Let's see how. So let's say my kid loves cars. So I'm just going to click on each image, delete it, and then go to Elements and search for a car. I'll filter this to graphics only and add my desired element. Adjust its size, place it wherever you'd like. Now you don't have to leave this blank. You can also already type in anything you want. For example, you can just expand this text box and add the name of my child. For example, like this. If you don't like the colors, you can always change the sticker itself and the text color. Just click on the sticker, go up here to the color palette, and change it to whatever color you'd like. You can also color the inside of the sticker. Just go to the second color box, the white one, and adjust its color. Now on my second page, in this same template, you'll find a different kind of design. I used some doodles, scribbles. You can change them just by searching for a doodle or a scribble, and do the exact same process. On my third page, I've added a blank sticker for you to either print as it is or add your own ideas. You'll also find in this tutorial a second template. In this template, you will also find three different designs. Now you might ask, okay, and now how do I print them and use them? So first of all, we need to go to share and download them as PDF print. Always choose PDF print because that would be the best quality for printing. Make sure you don't click accidentally on PDF standard. Once you click on PDF print, you can choose which page you'd like to print and the color profile, whether it's RGB or CMYK. You can use a sticker instead of a regular paper, and then just manually cut around your sticker. If you're sending this out to a printer shop, you should always mark the crop marks and bleed. Then you can ask your printer shop to either print it as it is or even print it as a sticker that you just have to peel off, and this is between you and the printer shop. So this is a great activity for you and your kids to create your own stickers. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. You don't need a Pro account for this, but if you'd like to use Canva Pro and have all the elements and photos available to you, you are welcome to click on my link below and enjoy 45 days of Canva Pro for free, no strings attached. Don't forget to click the bell and subscribe to my channel so you will be updated with every new video that I publish. I'll see you all in the next video. Bye for now.